I'm Larry Howard. I'm the University of Nebraska-Lincoln Extension Educator in Cumming County. And I have with me today Danny Kluthe, and we're at Danny's farm here, and we're going to be talking about his methane digester. And Danny, why don't you go ahead and tell us a little bit about your operation, how many heads you have, and how you got started with this digester unit.
Well, actually, I got a DEQ permit for 10,000, but I've got a six barns here that I run through, plus the nursery, run through the digester. So there's probably roughly 7,500 head that will go into this digester for methane gas production.
So how do you go about managing your buildings to get the manure from the buildings down to the digester?
Actually, the manure all drops through the slats into a pit, holding pit. I've got a valve on the south on every quarter and a valve on the north. One month I'll go south with it, and the next month I'll go north. That way we don't get manure buildup in our pit underneath.
So all six barns are plumbed down to that digester?
Yep. It's all gravity flowed, and when I come in the morning to do my chores, I'll open up the pull valve, and then I'll come back in here to the Gentech room and write down, you know, I log everything. I log the water temp, the KWs it produces, the amount of production that we produced in methane gas, and et cetera. And when I'm done with that, if the cover said I need a lot of production, we let it run for quite a while. And if the cover was pretty up and I don't need much, then we run a little shorter. But I monitor the cover on the digester to let me know this is how much I need to feed today. And I come in the mornings, and when I leave, that's pretty much my work for the day.
Let's talk about the digester itself. Why don't you go ahead and share with us the size, the cover, how often it gets fed, how often the mixing takes place.
Actually, the digester itself is 80 feet across, 14 feet deep, holds 440,000 gallons of good product, hog waste, manure. It's got a 40 mil cover over the top that's insulated, and it's got to be heated to 100 to 102 degrees. And the heat gets from the heat exchanger from the engine is what heats it.
So is the side of the tank insulated at all?
Yeah, 8 foot down, I put a couple inches of foam on that. And the top cover is insulated with 4 inches of recycled insulation. And actually I got a 60 mil cover, then the insulation, and a 40 mil cover comes over the top of that.
Okay, Danny, you talk about mixing. How often do you mix the product that's in the digester?
The mixer runs every 8 hours for a half hour. So it's a complete mix digester or manure processor.
So how do you handle the gas as it comes off the digester back into your engine?
The first filters out the suds and any debris or whatever. It's sucked up here. Up here I got filters to take some of the moisture out and some of the impurities out of the gas.
So what's the temperature of the digester, and how do you monitor that temperature, and how do you heat it?
Actually, it's heated by a heat exchanger that's in front of the 3306 CAT engine that captures the heat from the engine and from the exhaust system. Okay. And that is what goes down to heat the digester. In return, coming back, it cools the engine. So when I'm logging my temperature on my engine, when the engine is being cooled by the digester, it's running about 10 degrees cooler than when the radiator is running it. Okay. So when it gets up to about 100 to 102, the switch is over and the radiator starts cooling my engine.
So what do you do with the gas?
Actually, the methane gas is sucked up to run my 3306 CAT engine that's running a generator 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And about 3 years ago, I learned to compress this methane gas at 3,600 pounds of pressure. And we put it in CNG, compressed natural gas tanks. And I'm running 80% methane and 20% diesel in my 3/4 ton Chevy Dumex diesel pickup. And I'm running 90% methane and 10% diesel in my tractor. And they just purr. If you want to race my Duramax diesel pickup, you better show up with something because it wants to go.
So you're also generating some electricity out of this operation.
Yes.
How is that working?
It's running. It's the generator is an 80 kW generator, and you know it runs 24/7. The only time we're down is for maintenance or for maintenance issues.
And you're selling that? How's the selling of that electricity going for this operation?
Actually, right now, the first 10 years, I had a contract with Nebraska Public Power District. And then when it was up to renew that, the local Cumming County Public Power, my local power district, they were able at that time to take me over and purchase it all. So right now they're paying me exactly what Cumming County would be charged from Nebraska Public Power District per kW. So they don't really per se care whether I'm producing a lot or not because it's costing them the same.
Okay, so another product that we're generating is the nutrients from the manure itself. So let's talk about the nutrients that are coming out of the operation as well.
Yes. Actually, all of the manure that goes through this methane digester, obviously the methane, the digester captures the methane, which all of the manure that goes through this digester comes out odorless or 99% odor free. So all of the goodies stay in there, less the odor.
How many acres do you have fertilizer for to cover out of that lagoon?
That probably every year we could probably cover 600, 700 acres of corn. Of course, I don't have that much, so you know it's the neighbors around here. We got a hose drag that takes the product out. It's free at the digester, but they got to cover the cost for the hose drag. Actually, if you want to look at it long term, I take the hogs manure to make electricity and et cetera, and we process it. And I call this not so much a digester, but a manure processing system. And we go down to the lagoon with that, and then in the end product is fertilizer for the corn crop that we take and put back through the hogs. So it's kind of a revolving situation there.
So how long have you been running this operation here as we see the digester unit?
Actually, from my open house, I've been running 12 years. And one of the questions that, you know, came up was, can we do this on a hog operation? I can't picture it running any better. It's been running for 12 years and it's doing its job.